Hey guys, welcome back. I'm Marty McFly. I'm Mega Dad.
Hello, Mr. Corleone.
And this is Mega Family Gamers.
Try not to draw any undue attention my way. I'm on the trail of a hot new scoop.
I'm Marty McFly.
Newspaper business, say.
Okay, the other story.
Did you finish the story you interviewed me for? About Carl Sagan?
Yes, but those pig-headed editors at the paper rejected it. They said my story was slanted, and that I was glorifying a suspected arsonist. As if their stories aren't always glorifying
She's
the criminal
vermin that run
this town.
She's right in front of you, telling Carl Sagan is the arsonist.
So mad, I could spit.
The one that started the fire.
Of course I would. There's an ordinance against it, and it's so untidy.
What's the scoop?
I've heard rumors that something shady is going on at the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen. It's under new management, you know. And, oh, we mustn't jump to any conclusions, not till the facts are in. I hope to heaven it is just a rumor. That soup kitchen is the front line in the good fight. If it goes bad, what will happen to the Stay Sober Society? Not to mention all the charitable institutions that depend on me for soup deliveries.
You make soup deliveries?
You make hot soup deliveries?
It's one of my many small contributions to the good cause. Healthy bodies, healthy souls, or so one hopes. I pick up barrels of hot soup at the kitchen, and I deliver them hither and thither. Hill Valley Orphanage, the St. Francis Xavier Ranch for Unwanted Children, Foggy Mountain Home for the Incurably Insane, Shady Acres Rest Home. Oh, I can barely keep track of them all. It's a very big job.
Yeah, I can help you deliver soup. I donate a lot of time to charities.
Let's deliver the soup.
Which ones?
The, Mario Brothers.
Mario Brothers, yes. Yeah.
The Italians do so many good works.
If you'll just fix it so I can pick up the barrels of soup.
Now hold your horses, let's not get over eager. I drive the soup cycle in this town, and I'm not about to turn it over to an upstart. But if you're well connected with the local charitable institutions...
Yeah?
You can let me know when they're running low on soup.
I know a charity that needs...
As a matter of fact, I do know a local charity that's running low on soup.
Oh? Who?
The farm, the rest home, the asylum... The orphanage? The rest home? The farm for unwanted children? The rest home?
The rest home.
Those dear old timers. Soup is one of the few pleasures they have left.
Alright, so let's take the bike.
Alright, Edna. Just think of all those poor unfortunates and hold your nose. Mr. Donnelly!
What are we doing with this soup anyway? Now it's, I have to look at the hints because I really don't know what to do. If you never lay your hands on the bootleg crooch, there's someone else who can. Can you turn Edna's soup delivery service to your advantage? Where would you like to have the hooch delivered? You can persuade Tamika directly to Emmett's lab. Naturally, she only delivers soup. What lab? Oh, I'm a fool. Okay. About this subpoenas for Raya Rocket Drill subpoena.
This subpoenas for Arthur McFly?
Have you seen him?
For a few seconds in the soup kitchen, but I think he's gone back into hiding.
Brilliant deduction, Einstein.
Okay.
We'll get that subpoena delivered. My name isn't...
Michael Corleone!
Yeah.
For one thing, I'm a little lost where his lab is.
This might be a stupid question, but couldn't you have designed your rocket-powered drill to run on fuel that, you know, isn't illegal?
Illegal? What does law have to do with science? Science has its own laws. You of all people should know that.
Yeah, he's right. Anyway.
We'll get that subpoena delivered.
Subpoena delivered. Let's give it to Edna.
Nah. I don't think so. Maybe not.
What? What? Okay, so we need to her to deliver to Doc's
Hey, Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Corleone. Try not to draw any undue attention my way. I'm on the trail of a hot new scoop, as we in the newspaper business say.
You asked me to tell you if one of the local charities is running low on soup.
Does somebody need a visit for my soup cycle?
The asylum? The farm.
A farm for unwanted children.
Perhaps their parents don't want them because they eat too much.
What? This is so bizarre.
Hey, cue ball.
What?
The truck just arrived with a fresh shipment of, soup.
Soup? Soup?
Well, this is the regular soup, and this is the special soup.
Right.
Special. What are you doing?
I'm spicing up the soup. It's my secret recipe.
Listen, this ain't the Savoy, and we ain't here to feed these bozos no fancy soup. The boss has got a business to rebuild, so knock off the goofing and mind your post.
All right, just try the soup. Well?
I can see why you want to keep this a secret.
I mean, is it good or is it bad?
Where do you think you're going?
The kitchen?
The kitchen's for management only, Rummy.
He's got a gun. Whoa, that's where the special soup goes? That's all interesting.
I'm gonna keep that door open without some help. Huddle up, Emmett.
Huddle?
Just listen up for a second.
Any ideas about where I can get some fine? I can't get into the kitchen. This place is a little dusty.
Emmett, I can't get into the door over there. Those tables are jamming it shut.
The door? So your plan is to just waltz in there and take a barrel of alcohol?
No, of course not. That would be stupid, right?
I'll say.
Still, I'd like to get that door open. I can't do anything from out here.
Well, it's a simple matter of physics. A lever, some sort of stop. Let me see what I can come up with.
How about, well, did he come up with something?
There's no way I'm gonna keep that door open without some help.
Why can't he help?
I better not talk to him. I don't want to mess up his timeline.
Oh man, this is so hard. We suspect the soup barrels on the bankers contain something stronger than soup. You can't get in the kitchen, but you can still cause the objects in it to be moved. If it would help if you could keep the kitchen door propped open. If you can't get the prop open, maybe a friend could help. What, can you just do it?
There's no way I'm gonna keep that door open without some help.
What's that? Kitchen door, stack tables.
What are those tables for?
We keep a few extra tables around for our end of the month hobo soirees.
Could you move them out of the way?
Not a chance. I could throw out my back.
Spice rack.
Eureka!
Nice rack.
Yeah, we got all kinds of culinary enhancements back there.
It's kind of blocked off there, isn't it?
Yeah, but what can you do?
What about those barrels?
What about them?
What kind of soup is that?
It's not soup.
It's special soup.
Special soup.
What's special about it?
It's made for grown-ups, kid.
A soup for grown-ups?
That's right, kid. Be nosy. See where it gets you.
Oh, man. What if it were to be moved? Oh, okay. All right.
Excuse me.
You talking to me?
Could I have some soup?
Why is the soup in a barrel?
Because it's hard to ladle off the floor.
Can I have a bowl of soup?
You're a soup kitchen. What do you think?
Yeah, get some soup. Spice it.
What kind of soup is this? It tastes like...
Scrolle ribollita?
I was gonna say week-old cabbage.
Everyone's a critic. Look, all I got to work with is this two-bit soup in a barrel and spice rack that hadn't been restocked since the Coolidge administration. What do you think I should do to perk this slop up?
Let's see.
Put some spices. Paprika.
Paprika?
Paprika?
I just think it could use a little color.
Color?
He's gonna go get paprika. All right, I think now we can push that door. There we go.
Pretty neat, Doc. Nope, I'm still not getting through here. But at least those tables are propped up now.
But what am I gonna do now? Oh, fudge. No. Chocolate fudge.
Okay. I've got some more ideas about your soup.
Do tell.
Let's see. Have you tried...
Parsley?
Parsley? It might help to, compliment the mellow flavor of the cabbage.
Compliment the mellow... What are you talking about?
Trust me.
You might be onto something, kid. Let me see what I got.
Okay, so... That, at least it's propped up. But then... Let's hit the pipe then. I don't know what to do. Just hit the pipe, Marty. just hit it. Hit it. Okay.
Whoa.
Okay.
Ah, Miss Strickland. Come for some more soup?
Come now, Mr. Donnelly. You know I wouldn't set one foot in this mockery of all that is good and decent if the poor of Hill Valley weren't so dependent on Mr. Tannen's overblown show of generosity.
Was that a yes?
Just give me the soup before I gag on the hypocrisy.
Get rid of the alcohol.
I'll tell the boss you said hello.
I'll just bet you will.
And they picked up the barrel of hooch. Now all I have to do is to get it from her somehow.
Yeah, let's go get it. We're getting close, guys. Getting that alcohol. There she is. It's so hard to control Marty. Where's he going? Okay.
Hey, Miss Strickland.
Oh, hello, Mr. Corleone. I'm afraid I haven't much time. The meeting of the Stay Sober Society is due to begin very soon.
You asked me to tell you if one of the local charities is running low on soup.
Does somebody need a visit from my soup cycle?
Yes. The asylum?
Never mind, I'm wrong. The pool hall isn't a charity.
Certainly not.
I'm sorry about the way Einstein lit into you back there. I don't know what got into him.
Well, I hope you've learned to keep him under control.
Yeah, I found someone to keep him distracted.
Very good. Now let's see if you know your multiplication tables.
What's the Stay Sober Society?
You haven't heard of the SSS? They do the most marvelous work, taking hopeless drunken bums and turning them into former hopeless drunken bums. I'm one of the founding members. And not to say that I was ever, well, you know. Anyway, we've always met in the cellar of the Sisters of Mercy soup kitchen, but for some reason the new managers don't want us down there, so we're stuck. We've got nowhere to meet.
I know where they can meet.
I know a place where the Stay Sober Society can meet.
Oh? Where?
At the Brown residence.
The Brown residence?
You mean Judge Brown's place?
Finally.
I happen to be good friends with his son, Emmett. And he told me the judge would love to lend his place out
my
for,
mind.
You know, good causes like yours.
Really? Why, that's the most generous, public-spirited offer I've received in a month of Sundays. Please, tell your friend Emmett we accept. And the offer couldn't have come at a better moment. It's almost time for the meeting to begin.
You asked me to tell you if one of the local charities is running low on soup.
Does somebody need a visit from my soup cycle?
The Stay Sober Society.
The Stay Sober Society.
That's right. They'll soon be gathering at the Brown Estate, and we haven't provided refreshments. I can't get over the generosity of your friend Emmett volunteering his father's house for our meeting.
Huh? Wait there! Michael! What in the name of Thomas Alva Edison do you think you're doing?
Don't you get it? You need alcohol to run your drill, right? Those bootleggers at the soup kitchen won't let us get our hands on any of their hooch. But we can get Miss Strickland to pick it up for us and deliver it right to your door.
No, out of the question.
Why?
I can't just let strangers invade my parents' house. What do we know about these people?
They're sober.
They're sober. It says so right in the name.
Well, okay, but a pop needs his peace and quiet at the end of the day. This meeting is sure to be too noisy for him.
They'll be quiet. You'll be quiet, right?
Oh, yes! I play my tambourine very softly.
You hear that?
Yes, but...
But what?
But it's still impossible.
The thing of the Stay Sober Society.
Right.
What'll happen to them?
They can all fall off the wagon for all I care.
He's mean.
But I promise Miss Strickland. It means so much to her.
The answer is still no.
Okay, then forget the whole thing.
Okay, forget the whole thing. We don't have to test your rocket-powered drill tonight.
We don't?
No. I'll take the train back to Washington and I'll tell the folks at the office to give the patent to Dr. McCoy.
Wait!
That's it. All in the name of science.
You will instruct the members of the society to wipe their feet before they come inside.
Then you are Emmett Brown. I thought as much. You have such a righteous face. Edna Strickland, I don't know how to thank you for your generosity.
Oh, pleased to meet you.
The feeling is mutual.
I didn't know something
was
going on.
I've got a bad feeling about this.
You worry too much, Emmett. Now all we gotta do is serve that subpoena, and we're off to build your rocket drill.
And get my patent.
Yeah, your, patent.
Okay, now we gotta deliver the subpoena. And don't look at me, I don't know what to do. Emmett needs to find Arthur McFly. Who could point you toward him? Try talking to Kit Tanner. Okay, of course. Where those guys are washing their shoes or something. There they are.
What the hell, Matches? You got kiwi all over my socks!
Sorry, boss.
Get out of here.
He's mean.
How about you? Huh? I'm sitting at a shoe shine booth. You walk up. Either you're here to shine my shoes, or you got a death wish. Which is it?
I guess I'm here to shine your shoes. Here you go. I'm looking for Arthur.
I'm looking for a guy named Arthur McFly. He's my, sort of a relative.
Well, he's my employee. He's very busy today.
Since you're Arthur's boss, you know where he is, right?
He's at the, office.
Where's the office?
I forget.
Okay.
So, when do you think Arthur will be leaving the office?
When I tell him he can leave the office. Hey, you missed a spot.
Isn't that Arthur McFly's hat you're holding?
It was McFly's hat. Now, it's my peanut bowl.
He's mean. Can I buy that
hat? Can I buy Arthur's hat off you?
Could you keep your mind on your work, huh, shoeshine boy? I'm hanging on to my peanut bowl.
Can I have some peanuts?
Why not? I'm a magnanimous kind of guy. Go ahead, knock yourself out.
Oh.
Hey, kid!
Yeah?
What the hell is that? Hey!
Just like in the movies, run! Run, McFly!
What'd you do?
Come on, McFly! They're gonna run into manure. Where's the manure truck?
Give me that hat, you lousy crook! Emmett!
He got it. Run, Emmett! That's it.
Emmett!
The trolley, watch out. I think they jumped on.
Nobody makes a monkey out of Kid Tannen.
Oh, is that poop there? Gross.
Ow! Fix me up!
Yeah, yuck.
Where do you learn how to move like that?
Sandlot football. They used to call me the Streak.
Get out!
Well, then now we got the hat. Let's look at it. The hat. What are we gonna do with the hat? Maybe Einstein will know. So stick it to Einstein. We do have a dog, right? With the dog could sniff the hat and then it can take us to Arthur McFly. Where's the doggy? This is the second time we're using you, Einstein. You're a genius. Genius.
Hey, honey. Come here for a sec, boy. Hey, boy. Can you find the guy who belongs to this hat?
Where's he going?
Only one way to find out.
See? Genius. Doc saw himself. Oh, the apartment. It's the same apartment where the old lady lived. Interesting. The McFlys.
Yeah? Who is it?
It's McFly!
Shh, I know!
He's funny.
Hey, Arthur, can you come down a minute?
Do I know you?
We're family. I've got word. We are the law. We've got some...
We've got some important information for you, but we can't yell it. It's private.
Then put it in a postcard and send it. I'm stuck up here till the boss tells me I can leave. Sorry. Some other time.
What a baby. What? Let's try another one. Let's try we're family or something.
What now?
It's me again. Please come down.
Why?
We are the law.
We represent the law.
You don't want to go against the law, do you?
No, but I don't want to go against Kid Tannen either. And he ordered me to stay put till he gives the word. Sorry. Some other time.
How are we gonna get him down? Let's see. What do we got here? To get Arthur out, you'll need to go and get something from the town center. Seriously, I need help. I'm looking at a what town center? I got already the hat. How do I show him the hat? What if I put on my hat? Here.
I already did that. That's how we got here.
Exit the town square. Let's just go to the town, because I don't know what else to do. I have to go get something. What do I need? Biff? I mean, Tiff? Tannen? Soup, maybe? Soup? Turn around. That's it. Maybe that's what I need. I need soup.
What is it, kid?
So this place used to be a soup kitchen.
What do you mean, used to be? Despite recent changes in ownership, this joint is still available for the purposes of distributing food to the needy and the not-so-well-to-do. And no other purposes whatsoever.
Right. What's a tough guy like Kid Tannen doing running a soup kitchen?
Mr. Tannen purchased the soup kitchen from the Sisters of Mercy in an effort to repair his reputation as a respectable community figure after his fine name was besmirched by the malignant and maliciferous the actions of the misguided vandals that done burned down his place of business.
Speak easy.
I cannot confirm nor deny any claims of so-called illegal bootlegging at the just eat your damn soup, pipsqueak.
All right, so
mind if I look around a bit?
No.
Oh dear. Okay, forget about it. I do not want another bowl of soup. Shark. Speakeasy ruins.
I guess this is where the speakeasy burned down. How'd Doc ever get mixed up in that?
Stationer store.
You gonna buy anything?
No.
Then get out, Bob.
There he is.
Well, well, look who's back. They say rats always return to the scene of the sinking ship. Get him, Matches.
Oh, come on. I'm running again.
There, you son of a bitch! Right now!
I don't think they're in a talkative mood right now.
Get down here and face the music!
No way! I worked too hard to get it.
You can't get away that easy. Nobody put one over on Kid Tannen and lives to tell about
my grandfather.
You're dead meat, twerp! Better start composing your epitaph now, because I'm going to carve it into your face.
Not sure what that'll do.
In bullets! Get down here!
I don't think that picture's going to do anything but confuse
people. You're only making it worse for yourself.
Which is worse, kid's bark or his bite? Try recording while he's ranting. Okay.
The longer you stay up... there. What do you think you're doing up there, you scrawny little runt? Get down here right now!
We got it.
Einstein, help!
Lay off! Get away from that crazy mutt!
Go
Go away, dog. We're busy here. Go on, scram. Hey. Oh. Where'd he go?
You let him get away, idiot.
Okay, let's get to let's deliver the subpoena. Not the subpoena.
You have to deliver a lot of subpoenas.
Father's always sending me out to do these dirty jobs. He wants to expose me to different kinds of people. All he's exposed me to is a lot of new curse words.
We'll get that subpoena delivered.
Okay, so how do we get to the subpoena part? I'm just gonna keep, I think it go this way. I'm just gonna keep going. Alright. Okay. Finally. Alright, so now we push the button. We're gonna confuse Arthur McFly.
What now?
He sounds like George McFly.
Kid, right away, boss. Where's
Give him the
kid?
Subpoena. Give him the subpoena.
Arthur McFly?
Yeah?
Got something for you.
Thanks. A subpoena?
Ordering you to appear in court and provide evidence in the investigation into...
Kid Tannen? Take it back!
You can't get rid of it, Mr. McFly. Once you've been served, it's your duty to report to the court at the earliest possible time. Failure to do so could lead to a warrant for your arrest.
Arrest?
Wow.
But kid'll kill me. Stupid Artie. Holy cats, what am I gonna do?
I suggest you avail yourself to the protection of the court.
Oh gosh.
Finally, I find this is hard.
Well, served the subpoena, got the
I'm so glad we figured it out, but
Looks
we figured
like
it out. We're the
lab
main family heirs, we figured it out.
You do have a lab, right?
What kind of future patent holder would I be without a lab? Come on.
Doc! I'm off to get the rocket drill.
Good.
Come on, let's go. Time waits for no man.
Wow.
Are you sure this is gonna work, Emmett?
Don't let the ramshackle nature of my laboratory fool you. If all goes according to plan, we'll soon be in possession of the most powerful rocket fuel known to man.
That's great. How?
Well, it's very simple. This crankshaft induces a powerful direct current into the electrolysis chamber, producing hydrogen, which must be periodically released into the primary distillation barrel. While tending to the hydrogen, we'll also need to regularly sprinkle these shredded protein flakes into this aquarium of tuber bacteria to generate the necessary nitrogen to catalyze the reaction.
Cool.
Oh, hot! Extremely hot! The temperature of the reaction must be kept at a steady temperature of 623 degrees Kelvin by carefully pumping these bellows. Any questions?
Could you repeat that in English? Is there going to be a test on this?
Emmett? Why is there a brace of drunkards gathering on our lawn?
Sweet fancy Moses, it's my father!
So?
So, he doesn't know I'm engaging in acts of scientific exploration in here. He thinks this is where I go to pour through my law books.
Oh.
You attend to the reaction, I'll try to get rid of him!
Attend to the what? Can't we just start over after he's gone?
It's too late. The reaction's already started. Don't worry.
Oh,
I'll
no.
try to help you out where I can.
But...
Coming, father! Father!
Don't you father me, child.
Well, this is it, guys. We're gonna, when we get back, we're gonna try to keep this reaction going before losing out. See ya.